Inserting questions from question pools or old tests into a new test in Blackboard 9.1. We'll do this by mousing over Reuse Questions. If we wish to select questions that will be seen by all students taking the test, we'll select Find Questions from the Reuse Questions menu. That will take us to our pool selection and question selection screen here. You'll see your question pools on the left. Let's just pick a question pool from which to select questions. I can select more than one if I wish. It's generally easier, if the system will allow you, to show all of the questions by scrolling to the bottom of the question list and selecting that. Now it's simply a matter of going through, previewing the questions as needed by clicking the preview icon, and then selecting questions that you want to use. Once you've selected the questions you want, simply click Submit, and those questions will automatically be added to your test and numbered there. It is also possible to reuse questions from old tests. We'll just open up our available old tests, pick one. We can select questions here the same way. Do note that the default setting here is to copy selected questions. That means that a new copy of the question is put into the new test and the old copy is not linked to. If you prefer, particularly in situations where questions are coming from a test pool, to simply link to the question in its current location, you can make that decision as well by clicking this radio button. The advantage to that would be that if you find a need to edit this question later, there will only be one copy of the question. You can edit it there, and then changes to that question will be reflected in all other tests in which that question is used. Again, submitting. We'll move that question into our test. If you wish to create a block of questions from which each individual student will receive a random selection, we would recommend using Create Question Set. Selecting questions for a question set is very similar to selecting them for a test. We simply select the pool or pools that we want to use. Again, show all the questions if that's possible. And select the questions that we wish to select the random selection of questions for each student to come from. You can either select them individually if you want to select questions that you are confident of, or you can select the entire page of questions if you wish by clicking the master selection box at the top of the screen, like so. Then click Submit. You'll now get a question set down here at the bottom. We selected 124 questions, but we almost certainly don't want every student to get 124, or all 124 of those questions. This value right here, the number of questions to display, allows you to select the number of questions from this set that each student will receive. Let's say we might like 25 questions. We just set that and submit it. So now each student will receive, as questions 7 to 31 in this test, a randomly selected group of questions from our total of 124 questions that we selected. It is possible, of course, to set the points per question here. And if you want to remind yourself of which questions you selected, you can click this link and all of the 124 selected questions will show in groups of 25 by default, or you can show them all at one time if you wish. You can create multiple question sets within a test if you wish to select blocks of questions from successive pools and keep them ordered separately from one another. But basically, that's all there is to creating a test using questions stored in question pools and old tests.